Hello YouTube viewers, welcome to my show Future Friday, episode number 2, where we're gonna take a look into the moon. So let's get started. So moon, you have to understand, this is the only celestial body we ever went to. Why did we went? Cold War. As simple as that. We wanted to diffuse a World War 3 without actually starting World War 3. That's why it happened. We did not went there only once. We had multiple missions over the course of Apollo project. Apollo 13 almost fell, and we were there quite many times. Now, moon is quite useless to go to, practically speaking. There is no financial benefit to doing so. That's why government stopped the project. It's very simple. It's like there was no point. Heck, people themselves wanted to kill the project before even Apollo 13 accident happened. Then it got the renewed interest. And there is a movie, Apollo 13, you can watch for more details. So all things considered, we went to the moon and it had no point. So why talk about moon anymore? Now, if we want to make humanity more than, you know, Earth species, basically we want to make sure we are on multi-planetary species, we need to conquer the moon. Flat out, unless we reach to the moon, we can't go anywhere else. Like, moon is the only place we can actually build the space infrastructure that we're gonna need for, you know, large-scale Mars projects and large-scale Venus terraforming projects. So we need moon. Now, why do we need moon? Well, first, let's count the advantage of moon. First advantage, solar power will work miraculously well on moon. It will not work same way in Mars because A, Mars is very far, so light intensity is very less. Second, the atmosphere on Mars is not completely clean. In terms, there is dust storm. Some dust storms can last upwards of 2 years. So suffice to say, for 2 years, your solar panel will not work. So even NASA knows this, and that's why Curiosity rover has a plutonium power and basically radiation battery. And they are planning to build a small scale nuclear reactor, 10 kilowatt small scale nuclear reactor. So they know solar power is useless on Mars, practically speaking. So all things considered, what we are left with is moon. Why moon? Well, moon has a lot of energy, solar energy. And second, it has material. It has a lot of material that we can mine. Now, mining a material is kind of energy intensive, so we got the energy. Now, second part is the moon has very low gravity. That means all the materials are not packed very tight. It's kind of very loosely packed. So mining it is rather easy. However, we have to do the mining underground to make sure we don't have temperature fluctuation of, you know, ridiculous nature. It's not very good for your machinery if, you know, hot and cold is getting, you know, it will expand too much and contract too much and, you know, break quite soon, so to say. So we have to do all the mining underground, and the regular earth contains a lot of iron, a lot of aluminum. Both are quite useful, especially if you want to build large scale things. So we have the energy, we have the material, and we have to also understand one thing. Due to the lack of atmosphere on moon, coupled with the fact that moon has very little, you know, gravitational pull, making a rocket that can ship, let's say, 1 ton of steel from its surface to its orbit is rather very low. The amount of energy needed to do that is very low. That's why from leaving Earth, we needed Saturn V, and the lunar module had a small rocket to go from lunar surface to lunar orbit. You can easily do single stage to orbit on moon. So lower gravity on moon really helps us to actually mine the stuff, has the energy so we can refine the material, has the low gravity that we can send that material to space again. Heck, we can even build space elevator. Now, we can't build space elevator on Earth because of the ludicrous amount of length of cable we need, somewhere around 30,000 kilometers. And on Mars, it's less. And in moon, it's so less that we can build that with Kevlar today. So suffice to say, so moon, if we conquer the moon, we can actually go everywhere from Earth. So Earth to moon, and from moon to everywhere else we can go. We can build shipyards on moon. We can, like, moon is actually act as a waypoint where we can, you know, build a base, create a base, since it will be close enough in case of emergency that we can do evacuation or things like that, and it will be close enough for direct communications, and also we can manage remote operations of drones and things like that. It's a bit laggy but doable. So suffice to say, moon has a lot of advantage if we want to go ahead. If you want to be on Earth, moon has no point. But if you want to go to another planet or conquer the whole solar system like the TV series Expanse, we need the moon. Flat out, we need to conquer the moon. So that was my episode of Future Friday, episode number 2, The Moon. I hope you liked this presentation and had some understanding with it. And if you liked it, please like. If you dislike it, please dislike. Leave a comment, subscribe. And if you are free, press the bell icon. And I hope to see you second time or third time in the episode of Future Friday. Thanks for watching.